Hi guys, it's Carolina from Gotta Love Polish. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you're new. So in today's video, I'm going to share with you the Tonic Fall 2020 release. There's going to be a trio of donation colors in support of the Black Lives Matter movement and a four color fall capsule. So the Tonic Black Lives Matter trio are these three. These polishes are going to be a donation trio. The colors were developed with the help of LaTanya Murphy and Crystal Moore, and LaTanya and Crystal suggested the Harvey African American flag as inspiration for the trios. I'll have that information down below. 50% of the price of each bottle sold from October 10th through November 10th, 2020 will be donated to an organization that will be chosen with the assistance of LaTanya. So I wanted to let you guys know, LaTanya actually reached out to me herself for me to swatch these polishes. I am really honored and thankful that she chose me. I really love this donation trio. I love the meaning behind it. I didn't think I was gonna get all worked up about it. But this is a really, like, every little bit helps, guys. Like, every little bit helps. What you can do to educate yourself, to stop racism, to stop somebody from being racist around you, every little bit helps. And opening the conversation up is important, and bringing it up to the forefront is important. So thank you to Lindsay and LaTanya and Crystal for putting your brains together and coming up with this wonderful collection. Thank you so much. Wow, I did not expect to get choked up. So the first polish that I'm going to talk about is hashtag BLM. This is an inky blackened base packed with super shiny, sparkly, iridescent gold, green, teal, and cerulean shifting shimmer. Ooh, that's a mouthful. This is opaque in two easy coats. Guys, this was so beautiful. I wore this by itself, but I also used one of the toppers that came in with this trio and the topper that came in with the other fall trio, and I just thought it looked beautiful over, like, this polish looked beautiful no matter what you put over it, and even by itself. And it was so shifty, guys, so shifty. As always, I will have pictures and different videos on my Instagram if you guys want to go check them out at Gotta Love Polish. The next polish is Shine a Light, and Shine a Light is a jelly warm lemon yellow packed with super shiny, sparkly, iridescent, gold green aqua shifting shimmer. It looks great in two easy coats, and that is very true. I thought it looked pretty decent in two coats. I did end up doing three just because I have such severe staining that I feel like it's more noticeable with sheer polishes. And even though this had amazing formula and amazing color payoff, I just felt that I preferred it in three coats for me. You could also use a color correcting base coat, which I do believe Tonic has. However, I don't have that one. This one, it does say that it may cause some yellowing on your nail. It could be prevented with base coat. I wore this for a day and a half and I did not have any extra yellowing. But again, my nails are always yellow, so it doesn't really matter for me. But yeah, this one is really beautiful. I'm really happy with this polish just because it has a green shift that is, like, really noticeable once you have it on the nails, and I loved the way that this looked. And the final polish for the trio is Social Injustice, and Social Injustice is a topper, technically. It is a matte drying polish packed with red, orange, gold shifting micro chrome flakies and micro flakes and a sprinkling of green, blue, purple, fuchsia, gold shifting multi-chrome flakes that can be worn as a topper or as a standalone in as little to 2 to 3 coats. I did three coats and I felt like there was still a little bit of, like visibility of my nail. I would recommend, if you're gonna do this, I would recommend sponging it on, just because I just felt like the flakies are dispersed enough to be a topper, and so that makes it like a little bit like too thick if you're gonna wear it just brushing it on. I do this, just brushing it on onto the nail. So I would recommend putting one coat of this on and then letting it dry for a little bit and then sponging the rest on, and I think you're gonna get a lot better color payoff. Now this does dry matte, which looks amazing. Guys, I don't know what's going on with me lately, but matte polishes have been like, ooh, they've just been doing it for me. So this one looks great, matte or shiny. I did put it over hashtag BLM, and I did also put it over the Shine the Light. I think it looked beautiful on both of them. I think it would look beautiful on anything, to be honest. It does finish in a matte velvet finish, but I did put some top coat because I like mine to be shiny. Tonic also sent me Optic, which is their white polish, just basic white polish. This was amazing. It was basically almost opaque in one coat. I did do two thin coats with all the polishes, all the swatches that you're gonna see, but it was pretty much opaque in one. If I had done a thicker coat, I could have gotten it done in one. Woof, I can't talk. So this one here is Tonic's My Little Rainbow, and My Little Rainbow was originally developed for a holiday release. Lindsay received an extra beautiful, extra shifty batch of her favorite super shiny, sparkly, iridescent, warm, peachy, gold, green, teal, cerulean, blue shifting shimmer that she's used in past Tonic favorites like The Fairy Queen's Pure Imagination, My Love, Wish Upon a Star, Knackered, and the new hashtag BLM and Shine a Light also have this. As soon as she saw it, she knew that she couldn't wait to put this in a collection. This can be worn as a super impactful topper or a standalone color in just 2 to 3 coats. I did try it 3 coats by itself, and I felt that the gold flash was very prominent. However, I put this on a white, and holy cow, guys, holy cow. Like, this is my favorite topper to wear with a white. Like, it glowed so much that even my friend who saw me like swatching this one said, you're putting that on my nails next. The next topper is going to be Crush, and Crush is the sister iridescent flaky to My Little Rainbow. These flakies shift from warm peachy gold with pops of red, orange, green, teal, cerulean blue. It can also be worn as a topper, and I do think that this is great as a topper over everything, or you can build it up on its own. I personally think that it looks best as a topper. On its own, it would definitely need like the sponging method to get more coverage. At least that's my personal preference. I prefer to have more coverage than less, so that's just my opinion. But this is a beautiful, beautiful topper, absolutely gorgeous. And the second to last polish is Tonic's The Great Pumpkin, or excuse me, The Greatest Pumpkin. This is a red toned orange linear holo made with translucent dyes to let some major holo rainbow action shine through. This is opaque in 2 coats, and this, guys, is the shiniest holo orange I have in my collection. Like, whoa, like I couldn't believe. I was just, at first I saw it and I was like, oh yeah, that's pretty, but I have an orange that's like, you know, holo orange. No, this is something special. This is actually really special. Like, I can throw away all of my other holo oranges and I will be fine because I have this one. That's how special this is. I really love this one. And then the final polish in the fall capsule is Fatigued. And Fatigued is a perfect fall holo. This is a brown leaning army fatigue green linear holo and is made with translucent dyes to let some major holo rainbow action shine through. This was a completely opaque in 2 coats, no problem. It looks black in the bottle at some angles, but it really is like this OD green color. And if you guys didn't know, I was in the military, and so OD green, I have a love-hate relationship with OD green colors, just because, like, the olive drab colors, the, you know, it's just something that like reminds me of my like basic training days and going out into the field. And I some days I want to wear them, some days I don't, but this one, oh god, this is beautiful. I have no other green hollow like this in my collection. None, zero, zip. Beautiful, guys, beautiful. If you like hollows, you're going to love, because you see that great flare, that is on your nails. It is so pretty, guys. I kid you not, I can't stress enough how beautiful this is. All right, guys, so that's it. That's my swatch and review for the Tonic 2020 Fall Collection and Black Lives Matter Trio. I hope that you guys, if you can, get your hands on these polishes. These are like seriously beautiful, beautiful. You will not regret getting these polishes. Like, they're just, I can't stress enough how beautiful these are. Like, seriously. They just blow my mind, like completely blow my mind. I love them. So again, guys, these polishes are going to be available at the tonicpolish.com website on October 10th. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give me a thumbs up, leave me a comment down below. Which one of this beautiful collection are you going to try to get your hands on if you can? I would really like to know which one was your favorite. Honestly, I have a hard time picking a favorite because these are all beautiful fall polishes, and you guys know how I am about my fall polishes, man. But if I was like totally forced to choose, definitely My Little Rainbow, like number one spot. I absolutely loved it over the White, Fatigued, and The Greatest Pumpkin, and Hashtag BLM are like, if I could only get the like four polishes, or like the minimum that I can get from this collection, I'd get those. Just because I feel like I just love these so much. Like, they're all great, but those were like the ones that I was just like, ah, really, really drawn to. All right, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.